In this video, we will cover how to best utilize the various views within Chief Architect. Upon opening a plan or layout file, directly above the drawing area, you will see a title bar showing the name of the current file and current view type. Any new views that are created or additional files that are opened will appear above the title bar as tabs to allow you to quickly switch between any of the available views. Each view type also has a different icon to help differentiate between plan views and layouts, cross-section views and camera views, CAD details and materials lists. To better help distinguishing which tab is which at a glance, plan files will display the current plan view used, and cameras will show the type of camera as well as the camera name. Similarly, CAD detail pages and materials lists will display the name they were saved with. You will notice the program will automatically increment the number of unsaved camera views, so as you're working on the plan, you may end up with camera labels that'll appear out of sequence, especially if they are saved with their automatically generated name. When closing a view that has not yet been saved, you may be prompted to save the changes to that view. This will not appear if no changes had been made within the view or to the camera itself. For example, you will not be prompted when simply opening a camera view, rotating about the plan, and then closing the camera. However, if you open an elevation view, then draw something like text, a dimension line, etc., you'll be prompted to save the view when closing it to ensure that you do not lose any work you've just done. Camera views can be renamed by clicking 3D, Edit Active Camera. Here you can also choose specifically if this view is to be saved or not, which is checked by default when the name is manually updated. CAD details and materials lists can be renamed by going to CAD, CAD Detail Management, or Tools, Materials List Management. However, all of these views can be renamed through the Project Browser side window by simply right-clicking on them and choosing Rename. If you do not see the Project Browser, it can be toggled on and off through the View menu. Every view that is saved within a given plan can be opened from the Project Browser as well. So it's helpful to save your views with descriptive titles. To be more efficient while you work, it's often useful to see multiple views at once. For instance, a 3D view and plan view, the plan and layout, or even multiple plan views. Views can be set to be tiled or tabbed as needed. The simplest way to do this is to open the views that you want tiled. Then under the window menu, choose either tile vertically or tile horizontally. This will automatically tile all of the available views, placing the active view first. To return to a tabbed view, from the window menu, choose Tab Windows. You can also manually tile and tab individual views. This can be especially useful if you have many windows open, but only want to tile two of them. To do this, simply click and drag the title or tab of the view that you want to tile. While dragging a window view, the program will display a shaded area showing where the view will appear when you release the mouse button. As you move your mouse across the view area, you will see it allow you to drop the view on the top, bottom, left, or right side of the current view. When the entire view is highlighted, it will drop the view in the selected area as a tab. This can be useful if you want to tab similar views but remain in a tiled layout. For example, having multiple 3D views tabbed on one side and plan and layout views tabbed on the other. You can arrange tabbed views and tiled views in whatever configuration you desire. But if you wish to quickly return to a fully tabbed view, simply double-click on the title bar of the active view and the view will be maximized with all of the other views tabbed behind it. If you are working with multiple monitors, you can drag views outside of the program window, and it will create a second instance of Chief Architect for that view. This second instance can be used in the same manner as the first, but be aware that the project browser and library browser side windows can only be displayed on one window. However, they will still function normally between all windows. If you enable either of these side windows where it is not currently displayed, it will close in the other window in order to open in the current one. The Aerial View, Tool Palette, and Active Layer Display Options side windows are all window-specific, so they can be opened and closed without affecting the other window. Note that any additional windows function as separate instances of Chief Architect in most ways. For instance, when all the views are closed from any window, or if the views are pulled from that window to another one, you will be left with a blank Chief Architect program window that will need to be closed independently of the others. Be aware, however, that many file menu controls affect all Chief Architect windows. So pressing Close All Views or Exit will do so across all windows.